Before I start anything, I just want to start off by saying I don't have the best mic right now. So if you... Shush! I don't have the best mic right now. So if you hear staticking later on in this video, I am sorry. I will try to do better in the next episodes. But anyway, my name is Nia, and this is the first episode of How Did They Do That? The premise of the show is I look at different special effects from television shows, movies, music videos, etc., and will basically show you guys how they did that, how the workers on the set were able to create those certain special effects. So yeah, welcome to the first episode, and yeah. Okay, so one of the first things that you need to do when it comes to this project is you need to make the liquid, and you need to buy the products in order to, you know, actually inject the liquid into your eyes, kind of. You're going to use milk or water, syringes, tape, tubes, activated charcoal. No, look into the camera exactly like how you were. In order to help me make the liquid and to also do the project, I had Randy, my sister Cora, and my girlfriend Adrian here with me.
We're gonna try one with water.
Right here, we're just trying to mix the liquid, but as we were mixing it, we kind of realized that milk probably wasn't the best. So we decided to switch to using water instead. And using the water ended up being a lot better. Also, quick public service announcement in the next videos. It's just gonna be of my sister doing stupid crap. She really wanted to be in it, so I'm gonna put her in here real quick.
Eyeshadow. This is what people with eyebrow makeup do, basically. Oh yeah. Girl.
The next step that we have is we need to prep, and what I mean by prep is we actually have to get the tubes to work, and we have to figure out how to basically inject the liquid through the tube so the water can get into our subject Randy's eyes. Right now I'm just trying to shave her face. I kind of did that by applying an oil to her skin, and then after that I kind of I took like a what is it called, a dermablade.
Why are you shaving?
So the adhesive doesn't like stick. And here's Randy right here quietly questioning if she should really put liquid in her eyes or not. Here's just me cutting a tube. I'm trying to measure out the tubes in order to put it on her head. I'm trying to measure the tubes to see if... I'm trying to measure it to Randy's head size so it can actually fit well.
Better?
Yeah, I think so. Because it can actually get in the eyes now.
Which is exactly what we want.
What I need you to do is hold it here and try to keep it like real. Let me see like how they operate it. Because they said like this was the hardest part. It was trying to actually get them to...
Careful about the eyebrows.
You never know, you don't want to lose that. Please tell me I can get this right. I'll just cut it. I'm kidding.
Yeah, cut it in your eyeball. I love that.
Oh, no, don't worry. I won't get your eyeball. I'm getting your dreams.
Thanks.
You're welcome. Okay, try to let it go.
Oh, shit, it works. Oh my god, get a close up.
It's kind of crooked, but you know what? It works. Even though I succeeded at sticking the tubes to poor old Randy's head, it still didn't work at all. I also kind of stabbed Randy in the eye with the tube. Girl, if you're watching this, I'm sorry. I really irritated the hell out of her eye, so she didn't want to do it no more. Understandable. So this entire process was just, it just did not work out, so I had to redo it again, but on myself this time. The next thing that you gotta do when doing this project is, girl, you just gotta squirt it. You gotta squirt the liquid through, you gotta squirt the liquid through the tubes and make, and through your eye to make it look like tears and whatnot.
So I'll have the camera, I'll bring this over to you, along with the water. Mm-hmm. And then you also need this. You need this?
Yes. I need the syringes, the skin glue.
And you need two syringes?
Yeah.
Okay. So that way we just want everything set. We only need probably maybe 10 seconds of a clean plate. It's just something just to, you know, get a base for.
Okay.
What are you saying?
This as far as it, is it, is it good? Is that good?
Yeah, that's cool.
Okay.
Wait. Oh, just move the orange thing up.
Here?
Yeah. Just squirt it back into the cup.
Mm-hmm.
And then...
Like that?
Yeah.
In order to make this work, what you're gonna need to do is you're gonna need to get a still shot of you, and then after that you're gonna need to get a shot of you with the tubes to your actual face. You're gonna be using both of these shots in editing. You're gonna kind of be blending the shots together in order to make it look like tears. You know what I'm talking about? Yeah, I'll show y'all, see more in editing or something, whatever. But yeah, Matt is he is going to be injecting, that's the word I'm looking for. He's going to be injecting the liquid through the tubes into my eyes behind that chair. You can't really see it, but yeah. And the final thing that we have to do is we have to edit now. We're in the final step. One of the most difficult steps, though. It's not like difficult, but it is difficult. You know what we're doing now is we're gonna take Matt out of our shot because he don't need to be there. Y'all need to see him out of this picture, the scene where I have the tubes in my face. We're gonna cut him out of that one, and then after that we're gonna blend him into the other shot where Matt is not there. We layered the shot with the tubes in my face over the one that didn't have the tubes in my face and where Matt wasn't there. So now we're just using the area where Matt wasn't there in the first clip, and we're just gonna blend both of the videos together. At this point, now we're just taking the tubes off of my face, just cutting around the tubes, and then we're just gonna remove them, and now it just has that huge ugly patch on my face that we're gonna fix later. And now we're on the other clip. Now we're trying to see how we can fit the other clip in with my face on the other ones. As you see, we're kind of just like, we kind of put the opacity down over one of the clips so we can see where they match up. So we're trying to match the shots up as best as we can so we can properly cut out the tubes so that it doesn't look as obvious that tubes were there before. And when you try to do this, it is gonna look a little bit obvious. As you can see, at one part, it don't look like I really have a hairline. And it also keeps looking like my hairline's receding the further that the video plays. And the reason that looks like that is because I moved when I wasn't necessarily supposed to. The video where I have the tubes of my face, that one is going to not be moving. I mean, that one is going to be moving, but because the video of me moving is layered over the video of me not moving, it kind of doesn't match up the best, and because of that, it makes it a lot more difficult to make it look seamless. Just don't move unless you're really good with masking and tracking and all that. Just don't move, or else it's just going to make things very difficult for you. Right now we're using this program called Mocha Pro in order to track the cubes in my head, and you're gonna see that right now. So we kind of put the grid over the tubes on my forehead. What that's gonna do is the system is going to basically go in frame by frame to see where I move at and then follow it. The grid is gonna follow the tubes. Okay, once it's done tracking, it's gonna take the tubes off of my forehead officially. And then what we need to do now is we have to use, there's this thing in the Adobe Premiere Pro called Anchor, and we just have to, what that does is it's gonna move that little forehead picture of me back down to my forehead so it can actually match up. So yeah, now we're just trying to match it up to the best of our abilities. But it looks a little weird. Ew, why look like that? That's nasty. Anyway, basically we got the tubes off my face. Now we're just doing tiny little editing to the overall picture in order to make it look more believable, like bringing that tuft of hair down. Like, we're just gonna be moving that tuft of hair down. The reason why I have this floating piece of hair above my head right now is because in order to make my hairline look better and more believable, we are going to be cutting out a piece of my hair from the still frame, and we're just going to be attaching that to the other video where I had the tubes in my head. And now we're just trying to match it up the best that we can. And now, in order to make sure that it don't look as sharp, and as well as to get rid of that weird dark patch on the middle of my forehead, we're just gonna do some color grading and some feathering in order to make it, you know, look better. And that's what we're doing now. We're just color grading my skin and stuff, and then we're gonna feather the hairline to make it look less like I went to a barber shop.
And now the editing is completely done. So this is what we have now.
And that's about it. That's how Billie was able to do her crying black tears thing. Didn't really look like tears. Looked more like a disease. But it was still nice though. It was still really aesthetic. And I liked it a lot. There are two things. Three, maybe two. I don't know. There are some things that I would note about doing something like this. The first thing that I will note is do not put the tubes like this, if that makes sense. Don't put it like this. Put it like this. Put the tube actually towards your eye duct, because I didn't do that. Because I didn't do that, it just looked wrong, and I wasn't able to place the tubes on my head or Randy's head correctly at all. And it took me 2 days to realize that I was doing that wrong. So yeah, just put it toward your eye like that. Another thing is make sure that the tube is above the eye duct. Do not put it in your eye like I did. Actually put it above the eye duct, because it's gonna look so much better post-production when you're trying to edit it out. Because when you cut around them tubes and you get toward your eye duct, it's gonna remove your eye duct, and so it's gonna look like you're crying out of nothing, you know? And that's just not, it's just not cute. So don't do that. Another thing that I will note is that this wasn't easy at all. I showed you one example of the project not working out when it came to like Randy. However, there were actually like multiple times that this did not work out at all. Nothing about special effects is really easy. Even the most simplest things take forever. So if you do want to do a project like this, don't be discouraged if you just can't do it sometimes, because just be like that. And yeah, that is basically all that I have to say. Would I do this again? Probably not. I mean, maybe. I don't really know. It wasn't like, it was fun. And then it got stressful. But then I got fun again when I actually figured out what I was doing. So like maybe I'd do it again, but I don't know. I'm gonna give this project a maybe if I'd ever do this again. Other than that, yeah. That being said, thank you for watching the first episode of How Did They Do That? And I will see you guys next week.